Imagine that you're in a supermarket and you are allowed to take any items you want for free. Unfortunately, your knapsack has a limited capacity. For example, 20 kilograms. And no, you're neither allowed to hold items in your arms, nor call your friends, nor go back later, just your knapsack. In this situation, you want to find the most profitable combination of items to take. In other words, the combination of items that has the greatest total value but without exceeding your knapsack's weight. And this is what the 0-1 knapsack problem is about. We are given the value and the weight of n items, the capacity of the knapsack k, and we are asked to find the total value of that optimal combination. In mathematical terms, we want to maximize the sum of vi times xy while respecting the condition of having the sum of wy xy doesn't exceed k and xi is either 0 or 1. Xi represents the number of times we take the item I. In our case, we can either take it once or not take it at all. This is why it's called the 0-1 knapsack problem. In future videos, we will see variants where we can take the same item more than once. Anyway, here is an example. We have these 5 items, each one has its value and its weight. And we have a knapsack of 20 kilograms. The best we can do is by taking the 1st, the 4th, and the 5th item, we get a total value of $55, and the sum of their weights is 19, it doesn't exceed 20. Now I recommend you to take some minutes to try to solve the problem before continuing this video. Ready to dive into the solution? Let's go! We have this first item, whose the value is $20 and the weight is 6 kilograms. Question, do we put it in our knapsack? The answer is, we don't know. We don't know if this item will be in the optimal combination or not. However, interesting suggestion, we can try both possibilities. We see what result we get when we take it, what result we get when we don't take it, and we compare. We take the maximum, obviously. Whether we take the first item or not, we move to the second item. Same question again, should we take the second item? Same answer, we don't know. We don't know if it will be in the most profitable combination. So same as for the first item, we have two possibilities, to take the second item or to not take it. Then third item, same thing, we can either take it or not take it. And it continues like that for each item. By the way, even if in the same level we have calls with the same parameters, but the actual state of the combination is different. You can find the recursion tree in the description to be able to take some time to visualize it. The result of this process is an algorithm that traverses all the possible subsets of items. And there are two power n subsets, where n is the number of items. Each branch represents a subset. And by traversing all the possibilities and comparing the total value, we cannot miss the most optimal one. It's the brute force solution. Okay, but how to actually evaluate a combination? To evaluate a combination, we just do the sum of values of items inside it, and we also check its total weight, to see if it fits in our knapsack. And here, from all subsets that fit in the knapsack, the highest value is 55, when we take the items 0, 3, and 4. To do so, we chose to first generate all the combinations, then evaluate them one by one. But we can also evaluate a combination while building it. 1. To not store all the combinations, which takes a lot of memory. And 2. To backtrack as soon as a combination exceeds the capacity, because we know that it won't fit anyway, so we just go back, we don't lose time. Let me show you how to evaluate while building the combination. At the beginning, we have full capacity, because our knapsack is still empty, so we have k kilograms available. And the actual value of the combination is 0, we didn't take any item yet. Now at each level, we have two choices, to take the item I or to not take it. We need to understand what happens in both cases. When we don't take the item, nothing changes, the capacity doesn't change, and same thing for the total value. We just call the function again, but by starting from the next item. But when we take the item, it will have an impact on the capacity and the total value. For the capacity, we have to subtract weights of I from it, because we have less capacity now. This is why, when we call the function recursively, we call it I plus 1, but k becomes k minus weight of I, to subtract the weight of the item we took. And remember that we said that once we get the two results, we compare and take the maximum. But for the call where we take the item, we add to its value the value of the item we took, it wouldn't be counted otherwise. It means that to calculate knapsack of ik, which represents the maximum value we can get with the capacity k starting from the item I, we compare between knapsack of I plus 1k, the case where we don't take the item I, and values of I plus knapsack of I plus 1, k minus weights of I, the case where we take the item I and we return the maximum. That's it. What about base cases now? We have the case where we finish traversing all items, where I becomes equal to n, the number of items. In that case, we just return 0 because we have no more items, we can't find any additional value. And the second base case is when the actual combination becomes too heavy for our knapsack, when k, the capacity, becomes negative. In that case, we return minus infinity to be sure that it won't be chosen as the maximum. We want to kinda drop it. And we got our recurrence relation. Knapsack of ik is equal to 0 if I is equal to length of values, which is n, to minus infinity if k is negative, and to max between values of I plus knapsack of I plus 1 k minus weights of I, and knapsack of I plus 1 k otherwise. A recurrence relation that we can easily turn into code. Note that I starts at 0, we want to start from the first item. And we solve the problem, we solve the 0-1 knapsack problem. For the time complexity, at each level we have 2 new recursive calls with one less item, and some O of 1 times stuff. We get T of nk is equal to 2 times T of n minus 1k plus 1. And we have a base case where we have no items left, where we just return 0, which takes a constant time. We can write T of 0k is equal to 1. We keep replacing in the recurrence relation, and we get a time complexity of O of 2 power n. O of 2 power n time is quite slow, can we optimize it? If we have a look at the directed acyclic graph of the process, we can find calls going to the same recursive call. It means that we are repeating work uselessly. And here comes dynamic programming to fix this. We will use dynamic programming to store previously computed results instead of computing them again and again. Dynamic programming has two approaches, the top-down approach and the bottom-up approach. Which one to choose? In our case, if we have a look at the directed acyclic graph of the process, we can clearly see that we don't need to solve all possible subproblems before solving the main one. Transparent subproblems are potential ones that we didn't need to solve. Is the reason why we won't use the bottom-up approach? The bottom-up approach solves all possible subproblems, even ones whose we don't need the result, which is quite overkill for this problem. This is why we will use the top-down approach, where we work the same way, but once we compute a subproblem, we store its result in a lookup table. And before we start working, we check if we didn't solve the actual subproblem before. If you're not comfortable with dynamic programming and its two approaches, you can have a look at the dynamic programming course, where you will find them explained and when to choose each one of them, plus 20 practice problems including this one. Link is in the description. To implement the top-down approach for our problem, we take the non-optimized recursive solution, we add a parameter lookup, it represents a lookup table, we initialize it if we didn't yet, and here we check if we solve the actual subproblem. Changing parameters are I, the index of the actual item, and k, the remaining capacity. So a function call is identified by the tuple ik. If we found the key ik in our lookup table, it means that we solved this subproblem before, we just return lookup of ik. Else, we work normally, but in recursive cases, we don't directly return the result, we first store it in the lookup table, then we return. And we solve the problem with dynamic programming. For the time complexity, we have n plus 1 times k plus 1 possible values of the key ik, because I has n plus 1 possible values and the capacity has k plus 1 possible values. So we have n plus 1 times k plus 1 possible subproblems. And each call costs O of 1 because we're just searching in HashMap, comparing values, etc. We get an O of n times k time complexity, where n is the number of items and k the initial capacity. We're done with this problem. We learned how to solve a 0-1 knapsack problem, a fundamental problem to know that has a lot of applications. I hope that you understood the solution. If you want to support the channel, you can like and subscribe to the channel, or you can buy one of our courses. See you in the next video, where we will discuss a variant of today's problem, fractional knapsack problem.